everyone. Welcome to the second tutorial video of week 3. So in week 3 we have learned a concept about Riemann sum. So what we do in this case, we are basically, suppose we are given a function, so we have a curve corresponding to that function. Suppose I am drawing a rough picture, suppose this is my graph look like, and I want to calculate the area under this curve bounded by this x axis, suppose from 0 to 1. In this interval, I want to calculate this area under this curve. So what we do, we generally take this interval and we divide it in some parts. Suppose here I am dividing it in 3 parts. So this is my point x1, this is x2, and 1 is my x3, and x naught is 0. So I am dividing my interval 0, 1. This is my interval 0, 1. I am dividing it in 3 parts. X naught, which is 0, strictly less than x1, strictly less than x2, strictly less than x3, which is 1. So our interval is divided in 3 parts. Now in this 3 part, I can take two kind of Riemann sum. One is Riemann left sum, and one is Riemann right sum. Or sometime it is called upper sum. So in this interval, we take this sum f of x I star. What is I star? I will say in a minute, and delta x. So and this I is going from 1 to n. Suppose I am dividing my interval in n parts, so here which is 3. So f of x 1 star, and delta x is nothing but the length of each interval, each sub interval. So if we divide in equal sub interval, then our length will be, so here total length is 1. So if I divide in 3, so it will be delta x equal to 1 by 3 for each case. So this is fx2 star 1 by 3 plus fx3 star 1 by 3. This is our Riemann sum. Now what is this x1 star, x2 star and x3 star? So we can take this xi star, if we take xi star as xi minus 1, that is the left point. So our x, this interval, this first sub interval is from x naught to x1, and if I take this x naught to be our xi star, then and the second sub interval is from x1 to x2, and our x2 star is in that case x1. And our x3 star is x2. If I take this convention, so I am taking the left point of each sub interval, as you can see here. So this is my x3 star, which is x2. So if I take my the left point of this sub interval, then I call it Riemann left sum. If I take the right point of this sub interval, that is my x1 star is x1. My x2 star is x2, that is my xi star is xi, then we call it upper sum or right sum. So this is right sum and this is left sum. So in this way we can approximate. So if we take x naught, then this will be the area which is less than the actual area, as you can see in the picture, it is less than the actual area. Now if we take the right sum, then we will get, let me draw another picture here. So this is my x naught, x1, x2 and here some are x3. So this is the curve. So if I take the right sum, then I am getting this as my area, as you can see here. So these pictures are really rough pictures. So yeah, it will give you an idea that we are getting this much error. Now as the number of sub interval increases, this error will become less and less, and we can approximate the area under this curve. That is the concept of Riemann sir. And as this n, that is the number of interval, as this n tends to infinity, we can come closer and closer to the area under this curve, and that is nothing but the integration of that function, which is fx dx in that interval here, which is 0 to 1. So as n tending to infinity, this Riemann sum will tends to this expression, which is integration of fx dx 0 to 1. Now let us try to visualize the whole thing in a GeoGebra using some graph of a function, and try to see how this Riemann sum approximates the area under the curve, or how it calculates the integration of that function. Okay, so we are using the same function x cube plus x square plus 1 as we have used in tutorial 1. So this is the graph of the function, and we will try to calculate the area under this curve in the interval 0 and 1. Now as you can see, if we consider this A will represent the number of intervals in which we are dividing this interval, this whole interval 0 and 1, and let's try to calculate the left sum. So suppose I am dividing it three sub intervals, then you can see the area under the curve which we calculated by Riemann sum will be this. So there are some error, as we can see the white area under the curve is basically the error which we come across if we take our number of sum intervals to be 3. Now if we increase the sub interval, you can see the error will be less. So if a equal to 7, we can get this kind of picture. So you can see the error is decreasing, and if we increase the number of sub interval again, suppose I am taking a to be 26 now, so you can see the error is very much less, and we are getting closer to approximate the area under this curve using this left sum. So now if I increase this further using this animation, so as you can see the number of sub interval increases, and it go to the number of sub intervals to be 100, and you can see we can nearly approximate the area. There is still some gaps, so it clearly it is much closer to approximate the area under this curve. So I can show the animation again. Yeah, so the number of sub interval decreases now, and see the error increases. Yeah, and that's how we can get a closer approximation of area under this curve using left Riemann sum. Okay, now again we come back to 0, and now we are going to see the right Riemann sum. So this is left. So this is my, when a equal to 3, this is our right Riemann sum. So you can see we will approximate from the above. So that's why it is called upper sum. So we will approximate from the upper side of the curve. So here we are calculating some more area when using 3 sub interval. So this area is more than the area under the curve. And as we increase our A, that is increase our number of sub interval, you can see we can come closer and closer to it from the upper side. Okay, so yeah, so you can see the animation how it comes closer and closer as the number of sub interval increases. Yeah, and again the number of sub interval decreases, which the error will increase now. So it will give you a visual representation how the Riemann sum works and how the area under the curve is calculated using Riemann sum or integration. Thank you.